In this video, we'll cover the process of creating RAID levels by using different strip sizes and read or write policies on Dell PERC. The supported RAID levels are RAID 0, RAID 1, RAID 5, RAID 6, RAID 10, RAID 50, and RAID 60. Please note that this configuration is supported only on hard drives or SSDs with H730, H730P, or H830 controllers. The H330 controller supports only 64 kilobyte strip size, with no read ahead and write through policies. The read policy of a virtual disk determines how the controller handles reads to the virtual disk. The write policy of a virtual disk determines how the controller handles writes to the virtual disk. To begin the process, turn on the system and press F2 to go to the system setup page. Click Device Settings, and then click Dell PERC. Now, click Configuration Management, and then click Create Virtual Disk. The system displays the supported RAID levels, depending on the hard drives or SSDs. You can select any one of the RAID levels. Here, RAID 0 is selected. Next, click Select Physical Disks. Select the physical disks according to the RAID level, and then click Apply Changes. The operation is now completed successfully. Click OK. Now select any one of the options from the Strip Element Size drop-down menu. The Read Policy parameter has the No Read Ahead and the Read Ahead options. Read Ahead allows the controller to read sequentially ahead of the requested data and to store the additional data in cache memory, while No Read Ahead disables the Read Ahead capability. You can select any of these options. Here, Read Ahead is selected. The Write Policy parameter has the Write Back, Write Through, and the Force Write Back options. With Write Back, the controller sends a data transfer completion signal to the host system when the controller cache has received all the data in a transaction. The controller then writes the cache data to the storage device. While with Write Through, the controller sends a data transfer completion signal to the host system when the disk subsystem has received all the data in a transaction. You can select any of these options. Here, the Write Through option is selected. The Disk Cache parameter has a Default, Enable, and Disable options. You can select any one of these options. Here, the Enable option is selected. The Default Initialization parameter has the No, Fast, and Full options. You can select any one of these options. Here, the Fast option is selected to perform fast initialization. Click Virtual Disk. To proceed with the operation, select Confirm and then click Yes. The operation is now completed successfully. Click OK and then click Back twice. Now click Virtual Disk Management to check if the virtual disk was created. Click the created virtual disk and then click Advanced. Here you can view the summary of the created virtual disk. For more information, visit dell.com/support.